This is Eddie Hearn, Matchroom Boxing. You are watching Sporting Icons. You don't need to be anywhere else.
Okay, so last month I did a video talking about fanboys, and of course I'm making fun of myself in that video as well, where I'm reading out a lot of comments. Of course, I'm not name dropping. I don't really like to throw people under the bus because the comments in themselves are embarrassing enough. But where fanboys are accusing other people of being fanboys, yet they're being the fanboy and they're exposing it in the very same sentence. Contradictions galore. Now, a lot of it does seem to center around Dillian White, Anthony Joshua, Tyson Fury, Deontay Wilder, which is why I've got that picture on the screen. But a lot of you enjoyed that video. You've asked me to do more of them to go forward. Again, I'm not going to be mentioning names or anything like that, so calm yourself down, but you may well recognize a comment. And if you get offended by any of these things here, well, I guess I'm holding the mirror up to your noggin. Anyway, we're going to start off with this particular comment. You're obviously a Tyson Fury fanboy because you hype him up too much. The King, Anthony Joshua, has beaten Klitschko, White, Parker and others. Who's Fury beat? Now, I know I don't need to really respond to that because I think most people could probably answer that question, which is, well, you mentioned Vladimir Klitschko. Tyson Fury's beaten Vladimir Klitschko too. Now, Tyson Fury, he deserves praise. He deserves hyping up. So does Dillian White. So does Anthony Joshua. So do a lot of people. Okay, but again, you're saying that I'm a Tyson Fury fanboy, yet you just called Anthony Joshua a king. Is what it is, right? Here's another one. That drug cheat, Billy Joe Saunders, is going to get messed up by the pound-for-pound king, Canelo. Now, okay, if you believe that Canelo is going to beat Billy Joe Saunders, I think a lot of people do, and that's absolutely fine, but why are you calling Billy Joe Saunders a drug cheat when Canelo had a 6-month ban on his resume for PEDs? Do I need to expand on that? I don't think I do. Here's another one. Actually, I said I wasn't going to mention names. I am actually going to mention a name on this one because I think this person does actually deserve it. He comments on a lot of my videos and quite clearly a Tyson Fury nutlicker to the extreme. Extreme. I hope this guy doesn't have social media, because if he does, and if Tyson Fury has his DMs open, I'm pretty sure this is the kind of person that will be slipping into Tyson Fury's DMs. Oh, I love you, Tyson. You're the best ever. Here's a picture of me naked. This is the kind of person it is. Carl Green. How are you, young man? Are you okay? Anyway, in brief, as I said, he comments on a lot of my videos, fanboying to the hilt with Tyson Fury, yet calls other people fanboys. Contradictions galore. Anyway, Carl, are you okay, young man? Yes, you are. Anyway, why are you making videos? Sorry, why are you making a 10-minute video criticizing Tyson Fury? Question mark, question mark, question mark, question mark, question mark, question mark, question mark. Well, firstly, I didn't make a video criticizing Tyson Fury. I made a video disagreeing with something that Tyson Fury said. Heaven forbid that somebody is actually going to have a difference of opinion with something that Tyson Fury said. Oh, poor you. Poor you. Another one. This is what he said today. Your love for Dillian White is embarrassing. Well, your love for Tyson Fury is fanatical, is extreme, and it's beyond embarrassing. Calm yourself down. I'm sure that you probably got your girlfriend. If you've got one, I don't know. Probably not. But if you do, I know you probably get her to wear the Gypsy King clothes in bed and all that kind of thing. You probably have big photoshopped images, big posters on the wall of Tyson Fury, half naked, just so you can sleep. Pictures of Tyson on your pillowcase. I don't know what it is. You are the fanboy. Think about it. You expose yourself practically every comment. All right? And no, I'm not going into my subscribers. I'm going in on Pratt's. Anyway, here's another one. Sporting Icons. Oh, it's not from the same guy, by the way. It's a different one. Sporting Icons. I don't know why you're such an Eddie Hearn rimmer. You talk like boxing is popular because of him, when everyone who knows just a little bit about boxing knows it was Tyson Fury who opened up the heavyweight division after beating Klitschko, then recently beat Wilder. You need to put more respect on Fury's name because your channel is getting embarrassing. I see this word a lot, rimmer and embarrassing. Well, firstly, between Tyson Fury beating Klitschko and then him beating Deontay Wilder, there's actually a 5-year gap. Do you think boxing was dead in between those 5 years? No, it wasn't. Now, you are correct, Tyson Fury, he did beat Vladimir Klitschko and that opened up the door. Okay, he unlocked the door. But it's Anthony Joshua who kicked it off its fucking hinges, was it not? Wasn't Tyson Fury done that? I'm a big Tyson Fury fan, and I'm proud of what Tyson Fury has done and accomplished, especially beating Vladimir Klitschko. But the reality is, boxing isn't popular because of Tyson Fury. Boxing was popular when Tyson Fury was on the sidelines, was it not? Boxing was popular because Joshua became heavyweight champion. Yes, and I totally agree that had Fury not beaten Klitschko, would Joshua have been champion by defeating Charles Martin and then having a fight with Klitschko and then on to Park and all that kind of thing? No, I get that. But it was booming because of Anthony Joshua. And who's at the helm of Anthony Joshua fights? Eddie Hearn. Why is it that most people here on YouTube, not everybody, but a lot of people here on YouTube are talking about boxing? Because of Eddie Hearn and his shows. Whether you like him, whether you dislike him, that is why. Okay? So again, you want to call me an Eddie Hearn rimmer, but you're clearly a Tyson Fury rimmer, is what it is. Here's another one. Why do you protect Fury? You claim Fury didn't cheat to beat Wilder, but you wasn't in the change room to inspect his gloves. Where's your proof that Tyson Fury didn't cheat? Again, I know I don't need to respond to this one, but I suppose my question to you is, where's your proof that he did? I've yet to see any proof that he did. All I've heard is people photoshopping images and trying to make things out that aren't really there. But here's the thing. Yes, you are correct. I was not in the changing room to inspect Tyson Fury's gloves myself. But I'll tell you who was. Deontay Wilder's manager and trainer, Jay Deez, was. The Nevada State Athletic Commission was in the changing room. The WBC Commission was in the changing room. The referee did check his gloves right before the bell went. And the Nevada State Athletic Commission got Tyson Fury's gloves after the fight. That's all the proof I need, young man. Is what it is. Here's another one. Gay J and the Gypsy Queen ain't happening. You're stupid to think it is when it's Wilder who will stop this fight from happening because he's owed the rematch. When he wins the court case, you lot are as stupid as F. He didn't say F, he said the full word. But, okay, so we're stupid for thinking that Fury and Joshua is going to happen. Yet, they're currently going through the date and venues right now. They've agreed all the contracts. Both teams are talking about this. This fight will be announced. Wilder, for all intents and purposes, when I did an interview with Bob Arum, he's not looking for a third fight. He's looking for a bit of compensation, which Bob Arum, a former lawyer who was part of the President Kennedy's cabinet, whatever it may be, has been his solicitor, lawyer, whatever you want to call him, he would know a little bit more about a court case than what you would. Arbitration, whatever. I don't know what the hell arbitration means, but he will know a lot more about it than what you would. And if Wilder really was stopping this fight from happening, then surely it would have happened already. Think about it. Okay, here's another one. Dude, close this channel down. It's a bit harsh, isn't it? Anyway, dude, close this channel down. Saying Fury and AJ is a 50-50 fight destroys your credibility. Fury dominates and knocks out AJ, easy work. If you can't see that, then you don't know boxing. Hashtag facts. Okay. I do wonder sometimes if some of these Tyson Fury fans who seem to troll a lot of the comment sections, I'm talking about extreme ones, are former Deontay Wilder fans, because this sounds exactly like Deontay Wilder fans used to talk about. Hashtag facts and blah, blah, blah. When there's a difference between a fact and an opinion. What you have said there is an opinion. Your opinion is that Tyson Fury dominates and knocks out Anthony Joshua. And that's your opinion. You're entitled to that opinion. I'm not saying you're not. But to say that we don't know boxing because we say it's a 50-50 fight, or I say we, I said it's a 50-50 fight. And it is a 50-50 fight in my opinion. But I'm not saying it's a 50-50 fight facts. I'm saying it's a 50-50 fight in my opinion. But you saying facts like you have a time machine, you went forward and you've watched the fight and now you've come back to comment. It's not a fact, it's an opinion. It may turn out to be a fact, but right now it's an opinion. Here's another one. Your Brits going on like UK is the home of boxing. Fury and Joshua is the biggest fight in boxing. Nobody cares about that fight or Undisputed. Wilder Fury 3 and Wilder Joshua are bigger fights than that one. Okay. You are an idiot. I'm going to move on. Here's another one. Who cares about this video or your opinion? Now, this comment was on when I asked about why Team Fury talk aggressively by Joshua. This is probably about 2 weeks ago now. So, who cares about this video or your opinion? Well, you do. That's why you clicked it to watch. Very simple, isn't it? Anyway, please cop in, please continue to drop silly comments, because I do enjoy doing these. It's not meant to hurt anybody's feelings or anything, except for Carl. Hope you're good. Anyway, drop your thoughts below, click thumbs up, subscribe, catch you all in the next video.